Today I'm with Mr. Todd. I'm not gonna show too much around, just his shoes, because we don't know how this play is gonna pan out. But he was feeling tired.
tired,
not well. I went to check out how it looks farther down the path. It looks okay. Meanwhile, he started feeling better, starts swinging. He says on the first swing, he gets a signal. What the hell, you getting a silver?
Yeah, 2021.
That's a freaking old one too.
Is there an edge on that?
That's a fish scale.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's bent.
It's bent?
Yeah. Take a look.
Get my glasses.
It's bent. Old and bent. Fishy. Could be fiscal, could be half dime.
Hold on, let me see. Maybe it's a love token.
Okay. Let's take a look.
I can't believe I got a fucking silver.
No swearing on my videos.
Oh, sorry,
again,
sorry,
please.
Sorry.
Because I get backlash.
Yeah.
You get a fish scale.
1890.
1890 fish scale.
Yeah.
Are we staying here now? Because he was doubtful off camera.
Look at that fucker. Oh, shit, I did it again. Sorry.
You can probably unbend it if you want. I mean, at this point, doesn't really matter.
Ridiculous.
Let me do a close-up.
That's ridiculous.
18.95 cents. Wow. And you said there is another signal? Swing,
yeah,
for it.
Well, just to the left. It's
we'll
deep,
though. We'll do live.
Hold on. Maybe it's different now that that's out of the ground.
Wow.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, definitely fish scale.
Gone now.
Maybe that was your machine hitting it with an edge.
Yeah,
now I'm going to be more careful on this freaking pathway, because I just casually walked.
13 right there.
I casually walked up. Could be a nickel. I'm American. Probably pulled up 13. All right. It's ground's very stony here. Anyway, a beauty. Yeah, it should straighten up. I would straighten it up a little bit. All right, congrats. Let's keep going. Well, in this hall, I got a jumpy signal.
Oh, it's a nice one.
And Todd already working it.
Oh, it's a nice one, dude.
Bucket lister for me.
Beautiful.
That was worth coming here.
Number two.
Wow.
When you get this stuff out of here, the dingler's going to still be in there. You're going to get a nice one.
Oh, it's not super old, but it's old enough. It's not one of those with...
It's 1800s.
It's 1800s. Oh, no, it does have the...
Yeah, it has the swirl.
Yeah, has the swirls.
Nice.
Sorry.
Congrats, bud.
That was like deep.
You know what? I probably came within 3 inches of...
Oh, yeah, you might have swung over it. It just sounded like garbage. Wow. Well, we're definitely in the right spot. We're digging every piece
put
of...
That down here.
No, you know...
Put that here. Pull that over here.
Okay.
Yeah, 23. Always a 23.
Well, it was deep. There might be another one. Who knows?
go to the bottom of the hill there.
Huh?
Go to the bottom of the hill.
There might be something?
Well, if somebody brought a... how the fuck did that get here?
Wow.
How the fuck did that get here?
Yeah, the hill is pretty steep.
Wow, you know what it was? A real.
We can go up that pathway too.
It was probably after a real big fucking snowstorm.
Uh-huh.
And the path was padded down, and they came through here with a horse and a carriage.
Yeah.
And you know what? There's probably fucking coral bells at the bottom of this hill.
Right there.
Yeah.
All right. Well.
And tumble.
Well, we're not leaving this bad place.
Look.
You're the one that go.
Fuck off.
He's been telling me he wants to go somewhere else. I think he changed his mind. Well, right next to where I dug the crotal bell, I got a meton. Look what popped out. A piece of crotal bell. Just the top on the mid-ton, 39 on 900. Sweet. All right, let's see if there's more. Well, I just got my first penny. It's from 1962. So hopefully the rest of the day goes a little bit older like that. So far. Hopefully next one silver. All right, so we went up the pathway. We couldn't find anything old. Just now got an overalt on the surface. Looks like we got Swiss Army type of, I don't see Swiss Army, but either way it looks like it should still be working. It's not very rusty. Sweet. All right, we're gonna go back where we found the crotal bell and the fiscal, and if we don't find anything else, we're gonna head somewhere else. Well, that was a good idea to come back here. Just on the edge of this pathway, I got a really scratchy signal. There's something round in there. Can you see it? Right there in the middle. Let's pull this out and see what that could be. Seems light. Light. Could it be large scent? Almost feels like a coin. Yeah, I think it's a large scent. Hello.
Hi there.
Yeah. Sidel Gracia, King George V. Awesome. We're gonna clean it up on for the wrap up. It's 1910 to 1920. Sweet. Definitely there was old traffic here. Right there you can see Georgie. Awesome. Alright. We're at a new wooded area. Look at what Todd found. Alright. Silver ring. I think this is one of those. Well, it says 925. Doesn't say anything else. I forgot what they're called, but there's chrome hearts, and there is another one that makes rings like this style, like. But there is nothing, no marking on it, so this could be just generic.
Yeah.
Still a pretty nice ring.
Pretty good.
Yeah. All right, we're just going through the woods. I'm on the edge. Right there, there's a river. Finally, I got something older. King George VI penny. 1940. Hopefully there's a quarter here. I'm kind of at the end of a promontory type of thing, so hopefully. Well, I'm at my old spot that I did get quite a bit before. Got a little iffy, jumpy signal. Look at this. First thing I saw this penny. 1941, and look at this, 1943 George dime. Sweet. Well, I've been digging pennies and finally I'm getting rewarded. Look at this, it says Pandora on it. Looks like a pendant or something. I'm gonna have to extract it carefully, but should be silver. All right, I'll show it to you when I pull it out. Pulled it out. Look at this. Look like we have intact Pandora pendant and necklace, technically. Not a big one, but yeah, still nice. There it is. Awesome. All right, I'll poke around a little bit more and then I'm gonna go home and getting hungry. All right, I'll see you guys later. Well, it's a bit of a mishmash of several hands. I did this about 3 hours in the modern park. I did get quite a lot of clad, close to $30 here, and I did another short one in another spot that got me about $5. There's some few older pennies in both cases, but nothing significant, nothing too much. And I also went to the woods where with Todd, where we got a few things. But the good stuff right here. So two large scents. Both are from 1919. Well, actually no, this one's from 1916. That's the one from a wooded pathway. And this one's 1919. Pretty good shape. This was interesting. Naughty talking heads I win. And tails you lose, or I lose. I didn't film the dime on I think this hand. I did the little area where previously I found older stuff, and someone was talking to me while I was digging, so I did not record it. So probably one of the last dimes from here, from that spot. And on the same day, I did get this Pandora pendant with a chain. Retails for about $95. I did find this. I don't know how old this thing is. Some kind of probably early 1900s. There's some kind of name behind. I'm not sure what that's for. Maybe a belt buckle type of thing. I don't know. Silver ring that came with all that clad. There was solid 1991, I think. Low 90s signal on Equinox 900. Another decent one, because it's Thomas Sabo. It retails for about $185, quite overpriced, but better than just plain silver ring. Weighs about 9 grams, so beats finding dimes. And finally, I did get a little piece, but this was the price. Early 1800s crotal bell, size 4, very nice condition, and it rings. All right, so that covers it, and I'll see you on the next 9 to Finder adventure. Take care, have a great week.